Hello and welcome to the next video lecture of Marketing Research. In today's video lecture, we are starting with model number 2, that is sources of research data. Now, in a model number 1, we have discussed some basic aspects about research, what are the various types of research, research designs. In this, we are gonna see about sources of research data and how to collect this research data. And in today's video lecture, we are concentrating only on primary data. So let us begin. So research data, what is research data? Research data is any information that is collected for research purpose. So research data is any information that has been collected, observed, or generated maybe through experiments or field work, or created to validate an original research findings. So research findings can be validated only if you analyze the research data. And in such a case, if you want to establish a theory or you want to test a theory, then you have to collect the relevant data regarding it and you have to analyze it. So the data that you are collecting for your research purpose is nothing but research data. Basically, research data are of two types. The first one is primary data and the second one is secondary data. So entire thing, what is primary data, what is secondary data, what are the sources of collection of primary and secondary data, what are the methods and techniques used for this. So all these things we are studying in the coming part of the model. So our entire model is concentrated on this, that is different types of data, that is primary and secondary data, and how are we collecting it, techniques and everything. So in today's video lecture, as I've said, we are concentrating only on primary data. So what is primary data? Primary data is basically the first-hand data that is collected by the researcher himself. So primary data is data that is collected by the researcher from first-hand sources. So maybe first-hand sources like people who have seen a particular incident, and you are going and interviewing that person. Suppose if there is a robbery that has happened nearby in a bank, and then you are going and asking the person who has actually witnessed the robbery, and you are recording the data. So whatever recording of data that you are doing from the witness itself, that is first-hand data. So first-hand data, you are collecting it yourself. So this is nothing but primary data. So various methods can be used for collection of primary data, that is like surveys through questionnaires you can do. You can use collect primary data through interviews also, or experiments, or even by observations. It is generally collected with the research project in mind. So see, different people do different types of researches. The topic of research, the subject of study that is there for the researchers will be different for various researchers. Now, the researcher, when he is collecting the information or the data, he will try to collect the data. If it is original data he is collecting, first-hand data he is collecting, he will try to collect the data that is relevant to his study, that is very specific to his study. So that is why the collected data which is there is very much related to the study, and directly he is collecting from the respondents itself. There is no middle way, or there is no thing that he is collecting from someone who has already collected. It is not the case. He is collecting directly from the respondents, that is the primary sources itself. Examples of conducting primary data or collecting primary data is when you are conducting a market research and you want to know something like consumer experience about a service station, or maybe you want to find out the consumer buying habits and you are observing the consumers in a mall. So if these kind of things you are doing, then observation and all, then this is nothing but primary data. Similarly, if you are interviewing trauma survivors, suppose there is an earthquake that has happened and you have rescued some people and the people are there in the hospital, and you are going and interviewing them and you are trying to find out what are their feelings. So this is nothing but primary data. Now, methods of collection of primary data. There are four main methods of collection of primary data. In short, I'll explain you this. First one is observation. This observation can happen either by human or mechanical way. Human way is, for example, some of your assistant or the researcher itself, or maybe an enumerator, he is observing personally and noting down the observation. Maybe he is observing a person's behavior. What is he purchasing in a mall? How is he purchasing? Whether he is just picking up the product, looking at the product and just keeping it back on the rack, or he's putting it in his shopping cart. So what exactly he's doing? So if the person itself, a human, is watching it and observing the behavior and he is recording it down, then this becomes observation through human means. Similarly, you can have observation through mechanical means also, like for example CCTV cameras or optical scanners, laser beams, so or laser counters, counting machine. So all these become mechanical observation. For example, CCTV cameras, you already know, are recording, are video records, recording is done through cameras, and this can be done, recorded and kept in a hard drive. So mechanical observation. Similarly, counting machine also is done. Counting machine is how many people enter into a mall. So a laser beam is set there. Someone who comes from an in, there will be two points. One will be in, where people can enter only, that is entry, and one will be exit. Now there is a laser beam. If person is entering in, he will cut the beam, and the beam, the automatically it will be counted as one. Three people are coming one by one in a line, so three times the beam will be cut, so definitely it will be counted as three. So this way counting machines also can be used, and this is again a mechanical way of observation. Second way is of collection of primary data is through interviews. Interviews can be in person or telephonic, that is digital also it can happen. In person interview is the person, that is interviewer and interviewee, both will be present and they will be meeting face to face, and a face to face interaction, that is meeting, will happen in person. The person will be actually visiting the researcher, or the researcher will be visiting the person. On the other hand, there will be the second type is telephonic interview. Telephonic interview is interview over telephone. Sometimes now, because of digital platforms, we can have interview over digital platforms, social media like Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, video calls. So all these things, Skype for example, interviews can happen. So digital format, that is, or using telephonic medium also, where the interviewer and interviewer are not physically present at the same place. They can be present at far away, and interview can happen. This way data can be collected. Surveys, for example, they can be online or offline surveys. During the lockdown, you might have come across many online surveys, that is feedback form or questionnaires being filled by the respondents. So online form can be filled. Similarly, offline, that is a printout of your questionnaire. Questionnaire is nothing but a set of questions, a feedback form kind of a thing, which you hand it over, and the respondent just ticks tick mark or whatever it is, he just answers it. So it can be either an online form, maybe a Google form or any other thing, email to you, or it may be an offline form. So generally through questionnaires, that is something like a feedback form. I'll get back to what is questionnaires in depth in further modules, but for the time being, understand that they are more like your feedback forms. Then the fourth type is researchers' diaries and notes. Many times when you are collecting, doing a research, a researcher maintains a diary and notes. So this can be used as primary data because the researcher himself has written it. So these are the four main types of collection of primary data. So in the next lecture, we'll discuss about secondary data and then other things about primary and secondary data. So for the time being, I hope you just see about what is primary data.